In this video, we're going to complete the KutaSoftware Infinite PreAlgebra free worksheet, Writing Linear Equations. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Our directions state to write the slope-intercept form of the equation of each line. So we're given a graph, and we need to take that blue line that's in each of these graphs and write the equation for it in slope-intercept form. What exactly is slope-intercept form? Let's quickly review. Slope-intercept form is an equation where we have the form of y equals m times x plus b. Remember, x and y are variables, so we need to find m and we need to find b. M is the slope of the line, and if you remember the slope, that tells us the steepness. Rise over run, change in y over change in x. So if m tells us the slope, b is that y-intercept. And what that means is wherever the line intersects the y-axis, that's that vertical axis here, wherever that intersects, that value is b. So let's take a look at number one, finding m and finding b in order to write our equation. So looking at this line, I think it's easiest to start with the y-intercept. Remember, again, that's where our line that's given intersects the y-axis, which occurs right here at a positive 4. So right away, we know that b is equal to 4. Now we just need to figure out m, and m is our slope. Looking at this line, we can tell whether it's positive or negative, like so. If you picture putting a ball on the line, if it's rolling down, that means it's negative. If the line was drawn this way, if we put the ball on the line, in order to move it to the right, we would have to push it up. That's a positive slope. So because placing a ball would roll down, that means we have a negative slope. So we know m is indeed negative. And in order to find the slope, we need one other point on the line. So I'm going to look for a point that intersects a grid line. And a grid line is where those grids cross perfectly. And we can see that our next point that falls on those grid lines is right here, the point 2, 1. So how far did we move in the y? We moved down 1, 2, 3. So there's our negative, and that's a 3 for the rise. All over, how many did we move to the right? 1, 2. So there's our positive 2 in that denominator. Negative 3 halves is our slope. Our y-intercept is b. So when we write this equation, it's y equals negative 3 halves x plus 4. And there we have it. That's our line in slope-intercept form. Let's move on to number two, continuing this concept. I'll leave our equation here, y equals mx plus b, just so we remember what we're doing. Now what we want is to find the y-intercept first, because that's where it crosses the y-axis, and it's easy to see that it happens right here at 0, 0. So our y-intercept b is equal to 0. Now we just need to figure out our slope. We need to find one other point on the line in order to use. And remember, we want to look for those good grid line crossings, which we can either move towards the right or move to the left to find that. Doesn't matter. But if I go left, moving up that line, we'll see that the next grid line actually occurs here at the point negative 3, 5. Or if I move the other direction, it would occur here at the point 3, negative 5. Now, in order to figure out that slope, it's rise over run. So starting with one point, you can see that we move down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and we move over 3. 1, 2, 3. So that's a slope m of negative 5 all over 3, negative 5 thirds for our slope. And again, we could tell it's negative because if we were to put that ball on our line, it would roll down. That's that negative slope, which we get by going down 5 in the y and over 3 in the x. Negative 5/3. Plugging those into our equation, we're going to have y equals negative 5/3 x plus b, or plus 0. But think about adding 0, that's adding nothing. So we can just leave this as y equals negative 5/3 x. Let's move on to our next problem, number 3. And number 3, there's something different. Right away, we can see that the slope is now, think about putting a ball on the line, we would have to push it to get it to go up. So that would be a positive slope. So we know that our m is positive, but let's start with finding b. Where does it intersect this y-axis? Right here at a positive 2. So b equals 2. So we have the point 0, 2. Now we need to find one other point where it intersects nicely on a grid line, which let's go ahead and use this point here. Now, we're going to figure out that slope. Rise over run, we go up 1, 2, 3. There's a positive 3. So far for our slope, we have a positive 3 all over 1 to the right. That's a positive 1. 3 over 1, that's the same as 3. So writing this in the form of y equals m times x plus b, our m is a positive 3 and our b is a positive 2. Y equals 3x plus 2 is our solution for number 3. And just to double check, let's pick a value for x. Let's say we plugged in an x value of 1. Then our equation would be y equals 3 times 1 plus 2. 3 times 1 is 3, plus 2 would give us a positive 5. So when x is 1, y is 5. Let's find that point. When x is 1, y is 5. Yep, it does indeed fall on that line. So feel free to plug in another point as a good double check. Let's move on to number 4. In number 4, starting with our y-intercept, we can see that it's here at a positive 3. So b is equal to 3. Now our slope, we need to find one other point on that line, and let's find a point where it intersects the grid line, because that's going to be a nice whole number, which occurs right here at negative 3, negative 2. Calculating our slope m, what do we have to do? Well, rise over run, change in y over change in x. So we have to go up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in the y. So that's a positive 5 for our rise. And we have to go 1, 2, 3 to the right. So that's a positive 3 for our run. So our slope is 5/3 and our y-intercept b is equal to 3. So that's going to be y equals m of 5/3 times x plus our y-intercept b of 3. Y equals 5/3 x plus 3 is our solution in number 4. Let's move on to the next page. For number 5, we have something unique. Think about putting the ball on the line. Would it roll down? No. If we pushed it, would it go up? No, it would just go straight across. So this is the case where the slope m is equal to 0. Because remember, the slope is rise over run. So let's pick our y-intercept point, which we cross this y-axis right here at a negative 1. So we know that b is equal to negative 1. If we were to pick another point on the line, let's say this point right here, how many do we change in the y to get to this next point? We don't go up or we don't go down. We don't change any in the y. So that's 0 over, moving 1 to the right, 0 over 1, rise over run, that's equal to 0. So plugging this in, for y equals mx plus b, we have y equals 0 times x plus b, which b was a negative 1. Think about 0 times x. 0 times x is just 0. So we have that y equals just a negative 1. So y equals negative 1 is our equation in slope-intercept form. Any point we pick along this line, what's its y value? It's always the same. Its y is always negative 1. If we plugged in 3, negative 1 for y. If we plugged in a negative 4 for x, it's negative 1 for y. Everything for y is always negative 1. So there's a horizontal line. Let's move on to number 6. In number 6, we can see that we have a positive slope. If there was a ball just sitting on this line, we would have to push it to get it to go to the right. We'd have to push it up that hill. So we know that's a positive slope. But let's start with our y-intercept, which happens here at a positive 2. So b is equal to a positive 2, and our slope m is equal to, let's find another point along this line, right here, at 2, 3. So our rise, the change in y, we have to go up 1, so that's a positive 1, all over 1, 2 to the right, that's a positive 2. So our slope is a positive 1 half, our b is 2, so y equals 1 half x plus 2. That's the equation for our line in number 6. And just to confirm, let's pick another value. Let's pick a value of, let's say x is equal to 4. So if we were to plug that in, y would equal 1 half times 4 plus 2. So looking at our graph, if we pick an x value of 4, our y value needs to be right here, which happens to also be 4. So let's see if we get that. 1 half times 4 is 2, and 2 plus 2 does indeed equal 4. So this line, our equation, checks out. Let's move on to number 7. In number 7, you can see we again have what kind of slope? It's a positive slope. But like always, let's just start with our y-intercept. Right here, we can see this blue line crosses this axis here. And that's at a positive value of 4. So b is equal to a positive 4. Now we just have to figure out our slope. Pick one other point that nicely falls on this line. I'll pick this point right here. Negative 1, positive 1. So rise over run, we go up 1, 2, 3. So our slope m is a positive 3 all over 1 to the right, a positive 1. 3 over 1 is equal to a positive 3. So our slope is 3, our b is 4. That's going to be y equals 3 times x plus 4. Now let's say you calculated your slope the other way. Let's say that you started at this point here and went to this point here. You went down 3, that's 1, 2, 3, so you would get a negative 3 all over 1 to the left. That would be a negative 1 because we're moving to the left. Negative 3 over negative 1 is still that positive 3. So either way you calculate that slope is perfectly fine. You're going to get the same exact solution. Let's move on to number 8. For number 8, you can see that we have a negative slope. As we go to the right, we're moving down. So let's find our y-intercept. Here is our y-axis. And where do we intersect the blue line? Right here at this point, 0, 0. So our b value is equal to 0. And our slope m is, well, let's pick another point on the line. This point right here. Positive 3 in the x, negative 1 in the y. So we have to go down 1. So that's a negative 1 in the rise all over a positive 1, 2, 3. Because we went 3 to the right. So negative 1 third is our slope. 0 is our y-intercept. So y equals negative 1 third, that's our m, times x plus b of 0. But remember, adding 0 is adding nothing. So we can leave this as y equals negative 1/3 x. And there we have it. That's all the solutions to this worksheet. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comments below or visit one of the previous videos where we go more in depth with slope, the y-intercept, and y-intercept form in general. But as always, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Happy learning!